Layout means any land whoever comes for development without building, it is called layout. Layout means subdivision of land with new roads. So wherever if you have any piece of land, 10 acres, 5 acres, any land more than 1 acre, it requires layout approval. For which minimum approach road should be 40 feet. That means 12 meter approach road required, and he has to leave 10% of open space for public purpose. It is free of cost, he has to leave. So that by this we are getting, for example about in Vijayawada, about 2000 acres of land has been approved in 1 year. So 200 acres of land we got in the form of pass, and about 600 acres of land has been taken over by local bodies in the form of roads. So roads and open space we are getting free of cost because of this layout regulations. In addition to this, they have to leave 1% for social amenities, transformers, garbage. So this provision has been recently amended in another place. We are insisting 1% extra for social amenities and 3%, 1% for utilities, 3% for amenities. In development control regulations, those are layout rules. Minimum 40 feet road, but depending upon site condition, we may insist 18 meters, 24, 45 meters, 60, whatever it may be. As per zoning regulations, we have to insist minimum is 12 meters. Similarly, in building regulations, if any site is less than 300 square meters, they have to leave only 1 meter or an open space. In less than 1 meter, they need not give any setback except front 1.1 meter. For all buildings above 300 to 750 meters, they have to, any applicant has to leave 1 meter greenery, green strip all around the building. This is being implemented in all buildings, except in some cases wherever people are coming up with another constructions, there we are unable to insist. Other than this, in all apartments, group development schemes, we are insisting 5% open space and also 1 meter greenway. 5% open space within the plot is for tar plot. This 5% is over and above the 10% that is left in layout open space. So in this 5%, it is intended for tar plot. In the areas where site is more than 1 acre, gated communities, in the community level, again they have to leave 10% open space as green area. For example, if any person wants to construct one apartment in 1 acre of land, he is eligible to construct 1 lakh square feet. In 1 lakh square feet, he can construct any number of apartments. There is no restriction. Only he has to leave setbacks, whatever is required as per rule. FSI restriction is not there in our case. And in addition to this 1 lakh square feet, he has to construct 3000 square feet for amenities. 3000 square feet for amenities in 1 acre of land. If it is 10 acres, 30,000 square feet is for amenities. Amenities means clubhouse, local convenience shopping, beauty parlor, something, whatever is required for local community. So this is applicable for only major projects. You can see in between Vijayawada and Guntur, such type of constructions you can see. There are about 30-40 major projects coming up. In many projects, 600, 800, in some projects, 6000 flats also they are constructing. Such huge projects are coming up nearby Vijayawada because of capital. Wherever any person constructs any apartment, even if it is individual building, he is liable for punishment for a period of 3 years imprisonment. That is law amended by government. As per recent law, he is liable for 3 years imprisonment or demolition of building or sealing of premises. These three strong act provisions are made available in the act. And also we made building construction permission system very easy. It is first of its kind in India, not only in India, in the world we can say. I will brief you of this, how it is working. Go ahead. water body. So any construction in building rules, there are certain provisions to protect water bodies. In previous days, people they used to construct all along river, all along water bodies, even occupying water bodies. Nowadays, we have insisted this provision. Wherever any nala or canal is there, which is less than 10 meters deep, he has to leave 2 meters buffer in addition to regular width, what is having in the revenue records and all. In addition to this, in private property, he has to leave 2 meters buffer for maintenance of this canal. This provision also we made. Wherever any tank, servo and all those things, there if tank is less than 3 meters, they have to leave 9 meters all ground open space. If it is more than 10 hectares, 30 meters all ground buffer zone to be provided. This buffer zone will be considered as 10% or 5% open space, whatever is legally required. So that provision also it is there. If it is river, say Krishna River, whatever developed is developed. In new areas, beyond municipal limits, he has to leave 50 meters from river bank. Within municipal limit, 50 meters within municipal limit, 100 meters beyond municipal limit. No construction is allowed along river Krishna, except with special permission of Water Resources Department. Already completed. Landscaping and all. These are all green building guidelines, energy efficiency, water operation structure. For all buildings above 300 square meters, water operation structure is mandatory. For every 100 square meters, 6 cubic meters of water harvesting kit has to be constructed. Waste management and all for insisted for major projects. Then this is the next one, online link. Online building permission system. It is for single system for all urban development authorities, municipalities. Earlier it was only for 110 municipalities. Recently, 1 week before, government has issued DO for implementation of online system for urban development authorities. Means Visakhapatnam, Tirupati, Godavari urban development authority, Kannur urban development. There are 9 UDAs in the state, including CRDA. So it is applicable for all municipalities and urban development authorities. First of its kind, under this system, architect has to upload any drawing, AutoCAD drawing. The system is scrutinized through AutoCAD, through automatic development control system. It is scrutinized and any failure reports is there. Then architect or engineer has to rectify it. After rectification, it will be uploaded again. Then fee intimation letters will be generated. There will be payment gateway made available. Immediately you can pay fee. Then you will receive the proceedings. This is simple system made available in Andhra Pradesh. There are certain technical issues and also human intervention indirectly. Some people are intervening in this. We are trying to control that. Anyhow, under this system, so far 50,000 as of now, 50,618 permissions have been granted. 96,000 units, 96,000 residential or commercial units, about 10 crore square feet permissions have been granted as of today. This is how it is working. Post verification is made. Actually, before giving permission, there is no inspection, only based on self certification of architect and also owner, these permissions are being granted. Wherever any misrepresentation is noticed, in that case, we have to revoke the permission. If it is grave violation, then only we can revoke, otherwise it is valid permission. Any person can go ahead with the construction without waiting for post confirmation. That is the system being followed. Nowhere it is being followed. Even China, America, US, even Singapore. Everywhere there is free verification is there. Post verification only in India, that's too in Andhra Pradesh we are following. Even Telangana also they are not following. This is successful method. But whatever certain issues are there, we are trying to resolve. We will get it paid off and we will make it successful. Thank you.